Despite the fact that they're dressed as villains, the 501st are actually really, really good guys. They do tons of charity and volunteer work. And the 501st is huge. It has thousands of customers broken into garrisons in countries all over the globe. Each member is assigned a special ID number once his or her costume meets a specific criteria for detail and quality. If you're a fan of the Empire and the Dark Side, this group is for you. Star Wars wouldn't be Star Wars without a certain little blue and white astromech droid, and he has his own devoted fan club too. They're called the R2 Builders. The R2 Builders is a group of fans who build actual functioning astromech droids and R2-D2 replicas. They're amazing, and the builders get really inventive with the colors and details on the units they create. R2 would be proud. Chris Gore talked to these R2 aficionados at Celebration 6.
Our club is up to 11,000 members worldwide.
Why do you love droids so much?
They're iconic and just darn cute.
This remote control is so sophisticated, it looks like a droid itself. Go.
Some fans specialize not in costume or droid building, but in bringing some of the amazing sets and props of Star Wars to life. Meet the Belgian Prop Crew, or as George Lucas once lovingly called them, the Imperial Dogs. The Belgian Prop Crew has built life-size versions of Jabba the Hutt, the Empire's bunker on Endor, complete with speeder bikes, and a giant AT-AT, which George Lucas himself signed. Their beautiful props are often featured at Star Wars Celebration for all to enjoy.
You've created a replica of the interior of the Millennium Falcon, other sets. Tell me, what led you to want to build one-to-one scale models? This is crazy.
Now, first of all, we started with costumes. Right. And if you have a costume, you like a background. Uh-huh. And you can use a poster or something bigger. And we like bigger.
Impressive. Most impressive. If you're a fan of mysterious, deadly bounty hunters, you're not alone. Meet the Mandalorian Mercs. The Mandalorian Mercs make, well, Mandalorian-style armor, which was made famous by Boba Fett in The Empire Strikes Back, Jango Fett in Attack of the Clones, and is also worn by Death Watch in The Clone Wars. They create their own characters, complete with a name and backstory, and bring it to life through their own custom armor. They mix colors and different decorative accents, resulting in really unique costumes with tons of personality. When it comes to designs, they're rather fearless and inventive, as Jabba would say. Thankfully, there are also fans who celebrate the good guys. Check out the Rebel Legion. The Rebel Legion covers the entire good guy spectrum, from pilots to Jedi to princesses, and they make their own costumes too. The Force is especially strong with them.